In this video, I just want to do a few more examples of solving equations using the square root method. So let's take a look at this one. I've got x plus 3 and that whole quantity, the expression x plus 3 squared equals 64. So once again, I actually have a perfect square on each side of the equation. Now take the square root of each side. So the square root of x plus 3 squared is just going to be x plus 3. And then, of course, I have to remember that even though the square root of 64 is 8, I want plus or minus 8. And now I'll just break this down into two equations and solve each one. So one of the equations will be x plus 3 equals positive 8. And the other is going to be x plus 3 equals negative 8. That way I take care of the plus or minus sign. So now I'm going to subtract 3 from both sides, and I'll get x equals 8 minus 3 is 5. So one of my answers is x equals 5. I'm in this equation, I'm once again subtracting 3 from both sides. So I've got x equals negative 8 minus 3 is negative 11. So my answers are going to be x equals 5 or negative 11. Here's another one. This is pretty much the same kind of thing, but it's going to require one more step. So I've got x minus 4 squared minus 9, and I've got to get this 9 over to the other side of the equation. So I'll just add a 9 to both sides. That's going to give me x minus 4 squared equals 9. And then, as before, I'll take the square root of both sides. I'll have x minus 4 equals plus or minus 3. And I'll break this down into two equations. X minus 4 equals positive 3, and x minus 4 equals negative 3. And I'll solve each one. So adding 4 to both sides, I end up with x equals 7. And over here, adding 4 to both sides, I'm going to get x equals, let's say I've got a negative 3 plus 4. So the answer is positive, and it's going to be a positive 1. So I can write my answers as x equals 7 comma 1. And one more. And the reason I'm throwing this in is because if you do the Khan Academy exercises, you're going to see problems with these directions. Determine where, and this thing is read as f of x, determine where f of x intersects the x-axis. And then you'll have an equation that looks like this. When you come to one of these, this is just a different way of writing the same kind of problem that you're used to. So all you have to do is, instead of this f of x, for these, put in a 0. So we're going to have 0 equals x plus 7 squared minus 25. And then I'm going to just flip these sides around. In other words, I'm going to put the 0 over to here and write it as x plus 7 squared minus 25 equals 0. And now it's just like the previous problem that we did. So we'll add 25 to both sides, and we're going to get x plus 7 squared equals 25, and x plus 7 equals plus or minus 5. Let's see if I can fit this in. So x plus 7 equals 5, or x plus 7 equals negative 5. Subtract 7 from both sides. So I'm going to get x equals 5 minus 7 is negative 2. And over here, I'll get x equals negative 5 minus 7 is negative 12. So I've got x equals negative 2 comma negative 12. Okay, so the point I wanted to make is just remember, if you see these directions, this is still a problem that you know how to do. All it means is you're going to take this equation that you're given with this f of x symbol, and instead of that f of x, you're going to put in a zero. And now it's going to be just like the other equations you've dealt with. Okay, so that's about it. Make sure you get plenty of practice. I'll see you next time.